Let's solve this linear programming problem using the simplex method and using the row operations tool for our calculations. It's a non-standard problem because two of the inequalities are greater than or equal type inequalities. It is a maximized problem, but remember, to be a standard problem, all the inequalities have to be less than or equal types. And so because we have these two inequalities which are greater than or equal, that makes it a non-standard problem. And of course, the first thing you need to do is to figure out what the numbers are that go into your simplex tableau. So review how to do that, and then we'll move on to the row operations tool to actually solve the problem. Here's what the simplex tableau will look like if you set this problem up correctly. So make sure you understand exactly how this tableau is obtained from the original inequalities and profit function that we were looking at a moment ago. The problem is non-standard. We do have these negative numbers in the far right column. So our first step is to pick either one of these and slide across to some negative number directly left of it. Let's pick the -4 and slide across and pick either of these. Let's pick the -4 in the first column for starters and look for a pivot element in the first column. Checking ratios, -8 into -5 is 5/8. 4 into -4 is 1, 8 into 6 is 3/4. The smallest of those ratios was -8 into -5, which is 5/8. So the -8 becomes our first pivot element. Let's kick into fraction mode and see how things work out working in fraction mode. So pivoting on the -8, this is what we get. We still have a negative on the far right, the -3/2. And to the left of it, we have a negative at this -1/2. So for our next pivot column, we'll use the U column. -1/8 into 5/8 does not give us a positive ratio. -1/2 into -3/2 is 3. 1 into 1 is 1. So this produces the smallest ratio working in that column. Pivot on this 1. And we still have a negative number over here on the far right. This -1, slide across to a negative number, and we get to this -3. So our next pivot element will come from the Y column. 3/4 into 3/4 is 1. -3 into -1 is 1/3. -6 into 1 does not produce a positive ratio. So the smallest positive ratio was -3 into -1, which is 1/3. So we pivot on the -3. And now everything looks good in this final column. Everything looks good in the bottom row. No negatives down here. So we're done. And we block out the variables whose column is in non-basic form. So Z would be 0. V would be 0. W would be 0. And the other values would be X equals 1/2. Y equals 1/3. And the maximum profit would be 96. So coming back to the original question, P is 96. We get that from the number down here. And then the X values, Y values, and Z values would be, slide this out of the way, X is 1/2. Y is 1/3, Z is 0 because of the form of that column. So X is 1/2 would go here, Y 1/3 would go here, Z equals 0. And that's it.